Hello everyone, I welcome you all to EduTap. So here we have brought for you another very important lecture under your GA series. So today in this lecture we'll be covering Feb 7th to Feb 10th, and let me tell you that this GA series is important if you are preparing for the 2019 exams of RBA Grade B, NABARD Grade A and SEBI Grade A. Also for the assistant exams of RBA and NABARD, both this series is going to be helpful. And telling you about our previous our courses which are being offered by us, you can see here that we are offering the individual courses of SEBI, RBI, NABARD and the combo courses as well. So if you are preparing for RBI and SEBI both, then you can get this combo course, similarly for RBI and NABARD also. Okay, so here you can see about our previous results. We are still awaiting the final confirmation from the results of RBA Grade B 2018, which was recently announced. So you can see here RBA Grade B of 2017, 27 of our students got selected. And NABARD Grade A of 2018, you can see here that there were 46 generalist seats, and out of the 46 seats, 26 were taken by EduTapians. So now coming back to lecture of the day, let us see what is your very first news. Okay. So this is about the zero fatality corridor. So Delhi government has come up with this fatality corridor, and let me tell you guys that in the previous video we had covered that 30th road safety week was being celebrated all across India, and as part of that celebration only Delhi government has come up with this fatality corridor. Okay, so that is why we are covering this news here. And secondly, we'll see what is the importance of this zero fatality corridor, ZFC. So there is this particular stretch of the outer ring road of Delhi, you can see here, the two circles between this, but in this stretch this zero fatality corridor has been launched. And the important thing is that this initiative is has been launched in collaboration with an NGO, Save Life Foundation. So Save Life Foundation is the NGO which is working with Delhi government, and they are working for reducing the road crash deaths. Okay, and earlier the ZFC model of the same foundation had also proven successful on the Mumbai Pune expressway, where they were able to reduce 30% of the deaths. So various steps which they take include road engineering, then police enforcement, rapid emergency care. All these things are provided in this particular corridor, and the stretch which is mentioned here is actually considered as a very prone area for the road accidents. So keep in mind that zero fatality corridor has been launched recently by Delhi government after the success of the same NGO, Save Life Foundation, in the Mumbai Pune expressway. Okay, so that would be it from this news. Now this is important, Parmanu Tech 2019. So this is actually a conference, Parmanu Tech conference. So it was organized in the national capital, New Delhi, and it is a joint initiative of the Department of Atomic Energy and the Ministry of External Affairs. So these two, Department of Atomic Energy is actually directly under the Prime Minister, so, and the Ministry of External Affairs, they have come together for the organization of this Parmanu Tech conference. So it is actually aimed at showcasing the societal applications whichever are made the Department of Atomic Energy is pursuing. So their efforts, what is their societal application, is particularly discussed in this conference. And the organizing authorities are important, and apart from that I have mentioned the specific sectors on which the discussion has taken place. So three important sectors were healthcare, first of all, related to nuclear medicine and radiation therapy. So this is very important, the role of the Department of Atomic Energy here. Then food preservation, agriculture, industrial applications, again from farm to factories. Then finally, India's capabilities in the nuclear energy. So you can see what is the important role of DEA, Department of Atomic Energy, in all these three sectors. And this conference was organized in the national capital, New Delhi. You can see here, it is written here. Okay, so that would be it about this conference. So this is about this Darwaza Band campaign. See, part two of this campaign has been launched. It has been produced by the Union Ministry of Drinking Water and Sanitation. Now let me tell you one thing. This Darwaza Band campaign, this one is the part two. The second part of the first campaign, you can see here, the brand ambassador is actually Amitabh Bachchan. So he is being starred here in this campaign again. So this is actually a part, I will tell you the broader perspective of this. So This has been produced by Union Ministry of this drinking water, and it is actually a part of Swachh Bharat Mission Grameen. So SBM has actually two parts. We have discussed it earlier also, and you must be aware that Swachh Bharat Mission has two components, two sub-missions, that is urban and Grameen. So Grameen component is being taken care by this Union Ministry of Drinking Water, and as part of that only they have come up with this Darwaza Band campaign. So it is actually the campaign which promotes the use of the toilets and to sustain the open defecation free status. And if it is not there, if the people are defecating, they are not defecating in open, they are using toilets, so that would become the motive of this Darwaza Band campaign. Okay, so apart from this, the campaign, important thing is it is being supported by the World Bank. So this is very important. And apart from this campaign, I would also like to discuss with you guys Swachh Bharat Mission itself. So this mission was launched by Prime Minister on 2nd October 2014. So 2nd October, as we know, is Gandhi Jayanti. On that day, it was launched as to come up by 2019. This is the year the Swachh Bharat is actually aiming to come up with the open defecation free status to all the villages, and it would be considered as a tribute to Mahatma Gandhi. So Swachh Bharat, this logo you must have seen many times. You can see here. So the two components I have mentioned here, Grameen and Urban. The urban one is managed by Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs, and Grameen by Drinking Water and Sanitation. So these were some important features of SBM. And I've told you about the Darwaza Band campaign, which is related to this SBM Grameen. And you have to know the personality which is starred in that particular campaign. Okay. So that would be it about this news. Let us move on to your next news. Okay, so France confers its highest civilian honor on the priest who is actually an Indian citizen. Okay, I'll tell you this. You can see here in the picture itself, Father Frenois Laborde. So he is a 92-year-old priest. He is actually his origin is from France, but now he is an Indian citizen, and he is working for the specially abled children and the destitute ones from past many years in West Bengal. Now, to recognize that, French government has come up with this highest civilian honor and has conferred upon this Indian citizen now, Father Frenois Laborde. So keep this in mind. He is working in West Bengal, and his organization is called as Howrah South Point. So Howrah South Point is the name of the organization, and from Bengal, he is the third person to get this highest civilian honor called as Legion Day Honor. So Satyajit Ray was the first person, then secondly actor Soumitra Chatterjee, and third award from the Bengal has gone to Father Frenois Laborde. Okay, so keep this in mind. Important personality here, you can see in the picture, he is being felicitated in this particular ceremony. Okay, Ranji Trophy. So 85th Ranji Trophy has just concluded, and the title has been claimed by Vidarbha team. Now this is very important because this is the second consecutive time that Vidarbha team has won this title. So they have actually won over Saurashtra in the final match, and Aditya Sarwate has come up as the man of the match. He is also from the Vidarbha team only. Okay, so these kinds of questions are important. They can be asked in the exam, and you have to know about the Ranji Trophy itself. So the domestic cricket championship, it is between the state cricket associations and even the regional cricket associations. I will tell you that this tournament has actually started from 1934. It is taking place, and the maximum number of times the team which has come up as the winner is Mumbai. So 41 times Ranji Trophy has been won by the team of Mumbai, and now this Vidarbha team has come up as the second consecutive winner. So keep this in mind, that the final match was between Vidarbha and Saurashtra. So that would be it from this Ranji Trophy. Okay, so this is again important. India's GSAT 31 satellite has been launched. So GSAT, we know it is a communication satellite. Earlier also we have discussed about GSATs and GSLVs in our previous videos. So GSAT 31 has actually been launched by the European rocket Ariane 5. So from French Guiana it was launched. Now we'll discuss about GSAT 31 and its relevance. See, it is a high power communication satellite and it is going to facilitate DTH services, then stock exchanges, digital satellites, news gatherings, all the broadcasting things would be covered under this, and even the e-governance applications would be supported. So broadly a communication satellite, keep this in mind, because all these things mentioned here are the features of the communication satellite only. So it is going to operate in the Ku band. We had discussed the Ka and Ku band. So the rocket, this Ariane 5 rocket, is also important because it has launched not only our satellite GSAT 31 but also the satellite from the Saudi Arabia. Actually, that is the satellite was from a consortium of Saudi Arabia, Greece and Cyprus. So two satellites were launched. One is from India. We have read about it now. GSAT 31, the high power communication satellite. Okay, so US has approved this missile defense systems for Air India 1. So first of all, let me tell you what is this Air India 1. So this Air India 1 is a mention to the aircrafts which are taking the or which are flying the Prime Minister and the President. So the specially secured aircrafts of the Air India 1 are called as the Air India 1. Okay, so now US has approved to sell the state-of-the-art missile defense systems for Air India 1 specifically. So Air Force 1 is the aircraft which takes the US President, and the security of Air India 1 is going to be at par with the Air Force 1 with this missile defense system. Okay, so let us see what are the name of these missile defense systems. So first one is this large aircraft infrared countermeasures. This is the first missile defense system. Other one is the self-protection suits. So whenever you get to know, if there ever it is mentioned the exam about Air India 1, Air Force 1 or these missile defense systems, you should be able to reconnect quickly. And for this particularly, two Boeing aircrafts would be taken from Air India, which would be set up with these two systems, so that Air India 1, that is the security of the Prime Minister and the President of India, are at par with the security of the US President. So that is very important. And another important thing is that US has approved the sale of these missile systems. So that means that is actually a kind of collaboration which is going on between India and US, and the warmth between the relations is also exhibited through this particular step. So that would be it. Okay, so this is about Helena. Helena is the helicopter NAG actually. So indigenously built anti-tank guided missile Helena has been successfully tested. You can see in the picture here, NAG is actually the anti-tank missile and Helena is the helicopter version of it. So that means the anti-tank missile, which is aircraft launched. So this is very important, you have to know. And why is this more important for us to know? Because it is an indigenously developed missile. So DRDO has actually developed this indigenously, and it is the considered as one of the most advanced weapon systems of the world. Okay, so keep in mind about Helena and the NAG missile itself. So I've told you about NAG also, that is an anti-tank missile. Okay, so this news is about your environment section. Great Indian Bustard is in news. Why so? I will tell you that there is this Convention on the Migratory Species, CMS. Under that, this Conference of Parties is going to take place in India in the year 2020. So why are we covering it now only? I will tell you that although this conference is going to take place in the year 2020, but now the government has announced its logo or the mascot for it, that is the Great Indian Bustard. You can see in the picture here. So this particular species will be the Indian mascot for this 13th COP, which is going to take place at Gandhinagar. So representatives from the various countries would be coming to attend this particular meeting. Now, CMS is actually under the United Nations Convention. So, first of all, let us see about this Great Indian Bustard. I'll tell you quickly about the important features. It is the one of the heaviest flying birds. You can see it actually looks like ostrich, but it is, you may even get confused, but it is not the ostrich. Important thing is that it is considered as a flagship species of the grasslands. So that means the health of the grassland ecology is determined by the presence of this Great Indian Bustard, and less than 200 birds are left in India now. So to make them more important, to make people more aware about them, this is particularly the motive behind the GIB, Great Indian Bustard, logo for this convention of migratory species. Now I will tell you about CMS itself. You don't need to go anywhere else and read about it. Just go through it and you'll be done with the CMS and the Conference of Parties also. So this Migratory Species Convention is an international treaty under the United Nations Environment Programme. This is very important that it is operating under the aegis of United Nations only. Then it is also called as the Bonn Convention, because the convention was signed in the year 1979 in Bonn, Germany. Okay, so if we are talking about Bonn, can you tell me which recent conference has taken place in Bonn? Not the latest one, but it is a very important conference which had taken place last year in Bonn, Germany. Are you able to recall that? It would be really appreciable if you mention that in the comment section below. That means you guys are not only going through the videos but also revising all the things which are being covered. Okay, so coming back to your Bonn Convention for the CMS. So it is a United Nations based intergovernment organization, and it is the only organization which works for terrestrial, aquatic, avian migratory species. So all three species are covered here. Okay, and under this convention, 13th Conference of Parties is going to take place in Gandhinagar, India in the year 2020. And you already know the mascot for that conference. Okay. ILO, International Labour Organization. So 100 years are being completed by ILO, and the celebrations, India being a founding member, India is also celebrating this ILO celebration. So let us see, you can see here, 1919 is the year when ILO came into being, and it was established as a part of the Treaty of Versailles. So we don't need to know all the features of this treaty. Just keep in mind that ILO is actually this International United Nations organization which is tripartite in nature. Now what is the meaning of this tripartite? That means it is collaborating with the governments, employers and workers. So a platform is being provided by ILO. And since 1919, India is a member of it. That means India is its founding member and is actively involved in all the activities which are taken by ILO. So that is it. Keep in mind about ILO. Yes, you have to tell me the headquarters of the ILO. Okay, that is your task of the day. You have to find it out and mention below. Okay, so let us see what is your last news from this lecture. This is the first ever World Pulses Day. So 10th February is the day when the World Pulses Day was celebrated for the first ever time. Now this is actually when in 2018 the United Nations General Assembly had decided to come up with this day. And if we are talking about this Pulses Day, you have to know that year 2016 was celebrated as the International Year of Pulses. So FAO, it plays an important role here, and that would be it. Keep in mind, we have discussed about pulses, and if you are preparing for NABARD particularly, I will tell you that we have covered this in detail in the ARD video section. You can go there and refer to that particular video. Okay, so let us discuss your MCQs then. MCQs would be derived from the same news which we have covered, so that you guys are able to recall the news and revise it later also. So I would recommend you guys to pause the video and try to answer the question. So, our very first question is, Parmanu Tech Conference 2019 is a joint initiative of the Department of Atomic Energy and which of the following ministries? So, this is important. DEA is already mentioned here. So, you have to find out the ministry which is collaborating with it. So, is it Ministry of Defense, Ministry of External Affairs, Science and Tech, Ministry of Skill Development Entrepreneurship, or do you think that none of the given ministries is collaborating with the Department of Atomic Energy? Okay, so our answer to the question is MEA option B. Question 2 is, which of the following personalities is the brand ambassador of the Swachh Bharat Mission's flagship campaign Darwaza Band? So do you see here that it is directly mentioned that Darwaza Band campaign is under Swachh Bharat Mission? So you have to know it is actually under the sub-component, that is SBM Grameen, and the ministry also you have to keep in mind. So, but anyway, this question is about the brand ambassador of this campaign. Amir Khan, Vidya Balan, Salman Khan, Farhan Akhtar, Amitabh Bachchan. So if you watch TV, you must know this answer even if you haven't read about it. Answer is option E, Amitabh Bachchan. So there is this campaign called as Indradhanush, which is related to the vaccination. That is also being promoted by Amitabh Bachchan only. Question 3, Helena, the missile indigenously developed by DRDO is which of the following? So you have to identify the type of missile actually, this Helena. Is it a ballistic missile, surface-to-air missile, anti-tank, air-launched anti-tank missile, or anti-aircraft missile? See, it is not the anti-aircraft missile. And the answer, two options can be confusing for you guys, anti-tank or air-launched anti-tank missile. So NAG is the one which is anti-tank. Heli-NAG stands for helicopter NAG. So that means air-launched anti-tank missile. So answer becomes option D. Question 4. Recently held 85th Ranji Trophy has been won by which of the following teams? Vidarbha, Mumbai, Saurashtra, Kerala, Tamil Nadu. So this latest trophy of under the Ranji match has been taken by the team of Vidarbha, and they have in the finals defeated Saurashtra. And are you able to recall the name of the player of the series? We have just discussed it. Go find it out then. Final question, which of the following species is going to be the mascot of the 13th COP under the United Nations Convention on Migratory Species? Okay, so this is an interesting question. Great Indian wild ass, great Indian bustard, red panda, Bengal tiger, or dugong. All these are very important species with biodiversity, which form a part of biodiversity of Indian subcontinent. And our answer to this question is option B. Okay, so here are your solutions. So that would be it from today's lecture, guys. If you guys have any query, then you can drop us a mail at hello@edutab.co.in. You can also call us or even WhatsApp us at the number given here, 8146207241. I would recommend you guys to visit our website also, www.edutab.co.in. And that would be it. If you like the video, if you like the content, please do not forget to click like, do subscribe to our channel and share this video. Wishing you all a very happy learning from Team EduTap. Thank you guys.